السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله رب العالمين. I am Munavira Farhana, daughter of Abbas Parambadan Tvpm. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, interpersonal relationship has much influence in molding one's personality. We must keep good personal relationship with others. Our relationship with our family, neighbors, colleagues, teachers and the public must be very cordial and friendly. Then only we can maintain a sound health. Personal relationships refer to close connections between individuals formed by emotional bonds and interactions. These bonds often grow from and are strengthened by mutual experiences. According to social exchange theory put forward by George Caspar Homans in the year 1958, give and take forms the basis of almost all relationships, though their proportions might vary as per the intensity of the relationship. In many cases, we see one makes bonds with other persons, keeping in mind that what he would get from the other person. That is, in a relationship, every individual has expectations from his partner. In their view, a relationship without expectations is meaningless. But as far as Islam is concerned, personal relationship must be based on mutual love, which in turn must be for the sake of Allah. If we love one person for the sake of Allah, it's an act of worship or ibadah, and we will not be disappointed even if our love is not reciprocated. That is, even if we don't get any advantage from the other person whom we loved, or even if he caused us some harms because we have not loved him for some personal gains, but we loved him for the sake of Allah. In one hadith we see our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Anas radiallahu anhu, salasum man kunna fihi wajada bihinna halawat al-iman man kana Allah wa rasuluhu ahabba ilayhi mimma siwahuma وَأَنْ يُحِبَّ الْمَرْأَ لَا يُحِبُّهُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ وَأَنْ يَكْرَهَ أَنْ يَعُودَ فِي الْكُفْرِ بَعْدَ أَنْ أَنْقَذَهُ اللَّهُ مِنْهُ كَمَا يَكْرَهُ أَنْ يُقْذَفَ فِي النَّارِ. There are three qualities which, if a person possesses, will experience the sweetness of faith. 1. To him Allah and His Rasul are dearer than all else. 2. He loves a man for Allah's sake alone. And 3, he has as a great reluctance or hatred of returning to unbelief or kufr after Allah has rescued him from it, as he has of being cast into hell. We should not have any hatred towards our brothers. In one Quranic dua, we see, رَبَّنَا عَفِرْ لَنَا وَلِيْخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَا بِالْإِيمَانِ وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا عِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. Here we may not, we pray to Allah. وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا عِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. O my Lord, and do not allow any spite, any hatred, any rancor to remain in our hearts towards those who believe. Our policy should be love for all, hatred for none. Actually, we should not hate anyone, Muslim or non-Muslim, good fellow or bad fellow. Even if we say we hate one wicked fellow, we actually don't hate that person, but we hate his wickedness. We must feel sympathy for him. We must pray for him to recover from his wickedness, and that is the real love for him. Once Prophet said to his Sahabi Anas radiallahu anhu, Ya Bunayya, إن قدرت أن تصبح وتمسي ليس في قلبك غش لأحد فافعل يا بني وذلك من سنتي ومن أحيا سنتي فقد أحبني ومن أحبني كان معي في الجنة. O my son, if you are capable of waking up in the morning and ending the evening while there is nothing of deception or hatred in your heart for anyone, then do so. O my son, that is from my sunnah. Whoever revives my sunnah, then he has loved me, and whoever loved me, he shall be with me in Jannah. So we should not have any ish or ghil in our mind to anyone. Love for all, hatred for none. With these words, I conclude my talk. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.